Hi, I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos. Today, I'm talking about how you can manipulate your body temperature to get deeper sleep. Deep sleep is what you need to wake up feeling rested. Deep sleep is one of four stages of sleep. Stage one is a stage where you're drifting off to sleep. Your brain waves are starting to slow down, and your muscles are starting to relax. And this stage only lasts about 1 to 7 minutes. It's very easy to wake up from this state with loud noises or someone calling your name. So some people can go in and out of this stage a few times before they actually fall asleep. Then you move on to stage two, which is still a light stage of sleep, but your heart rate slows down even further and your body temperature starts to drop. The first time that you hit this stage, you stay there for about 20 to 40 minutes before you go on to stage three. But as the night progresses, you spend more and more time in stage two. About 40 to 50% of your sleep is spent in stage two. Stage three is the deepest stage, called slow wave sleep. Everything is slowed down. Your brain waves are slow, as is your breathing and your heart rate. Your muscles are completely relaxed. This is the stage that's hard to wake up from. My parents used to call it being dead to the world. I don't know where they got that phrase from, but it makes sense to me now because it can take a lot to wake someone up from this state. They may not respond to calling their name, and if you shake them awake, they may wake up confused and disoriented. This is the stage that you're in when you're sleeping through the noise of an alarm clock. So it's like you're completely cut off from your environment, or dead to the world. The normal amount of time that we spend in deep sleep is about 15 to 25%. The last stage is rapid eye movement sleep, called REM sleep or REM sleep. And this is a very light stage of sleep where you dream. Your body is paralyzed so that you don't act out your dreams, but your brain is very active during this phase. Some researchers believe that REM sleep is very important for creativity. Everyone dreams, but you don't always remember your dreams. REM is supposed to constitute about 20 to 25% of your total sleep. Most of your deep sleep is front-loaded at the beginning of the night, and you get most of your REM and light sleep in the second half of the night. That's why if you wake up naturally, you may feel like you just woke up from a dream, and you probably did have your last dream 10 to 15 minutes before you woke up. So those are the stages. I mentioned that deep sleep is what you need to feel rested. Some important things happen during deep sleep. This is when your body tissues regenerate and repair. Memories of things that you learned get hard-coded in your brain, and you get hormone or growth hormone secretion. This is one of the reasons adequate sleep is important for children who are still growing. Your body clock or circadian rhythm cycle controls your sleeping pattern. And there are several things that influence your body clock. Light is one huge factor, and I've talked a lot about how using blue light blocking glasses 2 hours before bedtime can help you keep a consistent bedtime schedule. But another important influence is your body temperature. A normal body temperature is 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit, and that fluctuates about 1 degree in either direction over the course of a 24-hour day. Part of the sleep process involves a drop in your body temperature. So if you're too warm, you may have trouble falling asleep, or if you do fall asleep, you may not get enough deep sleep. About 2 hours before you start to get sleepy, your brain secretes melatonin and your core body temperature starts to drop. So there's a process that begins here. And here are some things that you can do to help your body get to a nice, cool temperature. The National Sleep Foundation recommends that you keep your bedroom between 60 to 67 degrees Fahrenheit. If you live in a warm climate like I do, it may be way too expensive to keep your air conditioning cranked up high enough to produce that temperature. One thing to clarify here is the difference between ambient room temperature and core body temperature. Your core body temperature is the temperature inside of your body, or particularly around your heart area. Your organs and your muscles generate a lot of heat, and your blood vessels help dissipate that heat by traveling from the big vessels inside of your body out to the tiny vessels in your skin where heat is released and you get sweating. The skin of your midsection and groin is called your proximal skin and covers your core body. the skin of your hands and feet is called your distal skin because it's a distance away from your core.
What?
Stick with me. I'm almost there. One of the ways your body cools itself is to push more blood away from your core out to your hands and your feet to warm them. This then cools your core because it removes heat from your core out to the outside. And the reverse is true. When your core is too cool, the blood vessels in your hands and your feet constrict and push more blood to your core to warm it. So that's why if you sit in a cold room, you may notice that your hands seem a lot colder than the rest of your body. And that's why you have to protect your hands from frostbite by wearing gloves. So here's what you can do to cool your body without having a super high electricity bill. You can take a warm shower 2 hours before bed. This heats all of your skin and in turn heats your body, but the process of cooling down after you get out of the shower triggers sleep since that's what your body naturally does as a signal for sleep. It starts to cool. If you don't want to take a shower, you can get similar results with a warm foot bath. Another thing you can do is wear socks at bedtime to cool your feet and use cooling objects to cool your core. I used to sleep with ice packs for years to get this effect until I met the sponsor of today's video, 8Sleep. If you watch my channel much, you know that I don't do many sponsored videos. Out of 200, this is 2 of 2. But I couldn't turn down 8Sleep's offer to test their bed, which they gave me at no cost, because I'm a huge sleep advocate. In fact, I even wrote a book about sleep 10 years ago. It's out of print, in case you're wondering. 8Sleep has directly addressed this issue of body temperature regulation by making a bed that cools your body, including your core. The magic is in the cover called the Pod Pro. You have the option of purchasing just the cover if you already have a mattress or getting their mattress plus the cover. The way it works is there's a hub that contains water that's pumped through an active grid in the cover. With their smart app, you can adjust the settings according to your needs. The app helps you choose a starting temperature based on your age and whether you tend to be a hot or cool sleeper. Then the bed temperature changes over the course of the night. I'm a hot sleeper, so I start out with a cold temperature that warms up as it gets close to the morning. The cold mattress at bedtime makes it easy for me to fall asleep, and then the warm mattress in the morning makes it easier for me to get out of bed. Each side of the bed can be programmed independently. Before I started using this bed, I had just gotten an Apple Watch and started monitoring my sleep habits. And there are other gadgets to do it too, like Fitbit. What I didn't like about the Apple Watch was that if I got out of the shower and forgot to put it back on before I went to bed, I didn't have any data. But with 8Sleep's app, you don't need to wear a watch. Your sleep pattern is measured by the pod cover that's on the mattress, so it detects your heart rate and body movement by your presence in the bed. You get lots of information about how much you moved around and how much time you spent in light, deep, and REM sleep. The hub, which I guess is the brain, detects when your room temperature has changed and will make suggestions on changing your bed temperature to optimize your sleep. The cost of the Pod Pro cover is $13.95 for a queen cover and $23.95 if you want the mattress with it. This is not cheap, but mattresses aren't cheap. This price is in line, though, with similar types of beds. What's nice about it, though, is that if you just bought a nice mattress, but you want the body temperature regulation, you can just buy the cover. You can get an extra $100 off the pod or the cover using the discount code Dr. Tracey Marks, and that's Tracey with an EY. If you purchase with that code, I receive a commission. If you don't want to purchase a cooling bed, you can do what I did for years and use ice packs or a cooling blanket. You want to use ice packs that have a protective cover so that you're not putting ice directly onto your skin. Good places to target on your body are your back, abdomen, back of the neck, armpits, and groin. A ceiling fan can also help keep you feeling cool, but some people can't tolerate the air blowing on them at night. So in summary, deep sleep helps you feel rested, helps with your memory, and promotes cell growth and repair. It's like putting your body in maintenance mode, and it's a very necessary thing. You can help your body maximize its deep sleep potential by manipulating your body temperature. You can do this by sleeping in a cold room, taking a warm bath or even a warm foot bath 2 hours before bed. Avoid doing things that heat your body, like vigorous exercise too close to bed or eating spicy food too late. Fun fact, capsaicin is a chemical compound found in chili peppers that stimulates thermogenesis, which is the process of your cells producing heat. So eating hot food can not only give you a hot mouth, but it can warm your body internally. Then the last suggestion is that you can wear socks to warm your feet while you simultaneously cool your core with a cooling bed, cooling blanket, or ice packs in strategic places on your body, like your trunk area, neck, armpits, or groin. I hope this helps you have a restful, deep sleep. Thanks for watching. See you next time.